Hello, ladies and gents. I'm the Rev. This is Indie Contact. Welcome back. Episode number 25. Hopefully everything's going okay here. OBS just changed their base program to the studio versus just this old one I was using, so I'm still trying to figure all of that out, so hopefully everything looks okay. Make sure, hopefully it's not dropping frames or anything, because it looks like crap on my little display. We'll have to see what the main screen looks like here. But anyways, this is Subsistence. Now, they put an update out this morning, first thing. I've been playing with it all weekend, so I thought we would revisit it. Now, things look a little different than the last time we were here. Completely different base. And we have armor now, so it is 1500 to get through this, which is good because I enabled the hunters. And of course we've still got our workbench here. This is where you upgrade all your weapons and you make the alloy, and you can then of course make weapons here as well. You can do that anywhere. Make a grenade, which I'll show you guys that. So, let's see. Some of the things we need to take with us on Alter Jaunt. Let's see. Yeah, we'll take the shoddy there. And the grenade. And we'll run around and see if we can find us any hunters here in a second. So, what else? Well, body armor. That's what else. As you can see here, I made a piece. And so, it gives me one little bit of warmth and 8% damage. Now, unfortunately, it doesn't say what those are here before you make it, so you could, you know, make a decision on that, which I think would be a good idea, personally. I mean, as it stands, you've got to make it, then you get to see what's what. But you got the combat vest and the combat helmet. Now, combat helmet, the big thing about this is headshots. Headshots will kill you faster than anything else. Same thing if you can pull a headshot off on a hunter, whether they have, now, he just updated it, so now the hunters, as you kill them off, they upgrade as well. If you leave them alone, they'll upgrade more slowly, but as you kill them, they upgrade faster. And they get to use the combat helmet and the combat vest, just like they use the handgun and the shotgun. So, let's see. How am I doing on food and water and everything? I'm looking decent for once. How's this thing going? Okay, so we probably should turn this back on. So, you will need the refinery to make the fragments that you need. And I think, yeah, I left that running all night, and it burned all my fuel. That's okay. But with most things, there are upgrades constant. You can add two additional lens total, one in, and then reduce the power consumption, because it's all about power in, power out. Now, your base thing here does slowly recharge in 0.06. And one of the ways you can work on that and get it in better and faster, more power, is solar panels. But put them in a better spot than where I did, because I stuck them in this, I'm in this cave here. You can see we're only at 60% life. I should have put it in a different spot. But improved sensors, so you can boost this up to 50%. And, of course, Oh wow, I gotta feed them. Okay, we'll do that real quick. Glad I checked. So how y'all doing today on this fine Monday? I hope everybody's good out there. I see we've got a few bodies watching. And how we doing here with our planter? Go. So, food and water. Let's see. Split. We'll give them tomatoes, because that will give you the best. It's the best when it comes to food and water for you and for your chickens. So not too bad. And since I left, I just put this one in. And this is our water. Our little ground display water thing here. When I can get up. There we go. And you must first drill down. Oh, and it hasn't drilled all the way down. Oh, well, I guess we'll just double that power there. Whew. That's cool. He's got a little bit of smoke on that. Now, you can double up your power on your generators, too. But since I've got all this juice here, and we need the water badly, we shall let that go. Now, I have not seen so far in any of the drops that I've been able to get, and the few hunters that I've killed, any weapons or body armor. So I don't know if that happens as you get further along or what. I just replanted all my tomatoes and my cotton. I think I'm going to have to do another box here to keep up with the production, because to make the combat vest, you have to have the padded cloth. And to make padded cloth, you have to have cotton. And the only way you can get cotton is to grow it. It'd be nice if you put that in the world, but what's this? Add grow light. Plants indoors throughout the night. Ooh. Oh, I don't think I have enough iron fragments for that. Power of growl. Oh, it looks like it should say grow light, but it only says growl. Okay, and of course that'll eat on your power all night. That's kind of what you're doing, is you're trying to figure out as much power to build during the day as you can at night. And that is off. Okay. How much do we have of these guys so far? 11 and 12. So, let's go out and do a little hunting, I'm thinking. Right? I think we got everything else. Now you'll see we've got a couple of bandages. So, 9 times out of 10 when you get shot by a hunter, you're going to bleed. Then we've got our little health kit. Gives you help, but doesn't stop the bleeding. So, you want to make sure you carry in both. And then, of course, grenade. Shotgun. What the hell was that? That sounded like someone shooting. Anyways. Of course, we've got our little pick and our axe. The axe used to get wood from trees. You know, and I'll just give you guys a real quick little run over. The first... Whoa, hello, bear. So there's... Ooh. Run, dude, run. There are bears and wolves. Oh, my. And they will follow you. The closer you get to them, the more likely they are they're going to attack you. Now, to get your various ores, that's potassium. I think we use that in to make ammo. And this looks like potassium, but it should be iron, I think. Yep. Ooh, this is good spawn here. And if you want a more thorough explanation, I did build a base over there in the previous stream, and you can go... Oh, hello, puppy. You can go check that out. I'm not going to try and fight any of the animals right now. For the simple fact that I'd rather save my ammo for the hunters. So, so far they're not too close. I've started and restarted, and every time I do, they are randomly generated in different spots. Again, part of any contact is I'm gonna. You know, I test a lot of the games before I even ever let them on my channel. So, wow. Boy, you know, my stream, but I can't tell if anything's good or not. Let me know in the chat if you guys, if everything's working okay, because YouTube and OBS are both just crapping all over my frames here. Which doesn't make any sense because my CPU's not being pushed. Neither's my RAM. Nothing. Oh, well, worst case scenario, we all figure out what's wrong and we will restream it tomorrow. And I'll just erase this stream. No biggie. Because I have had everything look weirded on this, then I check the stream later and it comes out fine. So, I do not know. So, the one telltale thing when you're out looking for hunters is fire. If you're running around at night and you want to do that when you can't see anything, they have the blue glow sticks like we do, so you can look for them. All right, so I'm gonna grab some wood real quick here. Hello, bear. Now, of the two, I found that bears, you can get a touch closer before they come after you. Versus wolves, they'll go after you. They have a shorter fuse, I guess. I don't know. But, oh yeah, ammo. So we'll just have to see here as we run around, do our searching, we find any hunters. They should be in the just beginning processes of building their base. I'd suggest you build your base, at least to the wood, completely with wood before you turn the hunters on, because they throw hand grenades and other fun things at your base. And if you just start, I mean, the amount of time it takes you to build your base and everything versus before the hunters start coming after you, it's too short a period of time, so you're gonna get lit up pretty quick. At least that's been my experience. As always, this is early access, so another really cool thing about this one. Oh, and if you see these big trees, make sure you go to them. I thought I saw something else. Because I think you get 6 pieces of wood from each. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Yep, there we go. All right. So as always, as you're running around, make sure you are using your crafting menu. The other big telltale sign is you'll hear them chopping wood. Or you'll just see one. Really? Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Ah! And I got killed. You go, my God. Well, so you can see the hitboxes and everything are shit. I hope I didn't just lose everything. That's really going to piss me off. Okay, so where did it drop me? So before, when the hunters killed you, they would, you would lose all of your stuff. I'm hoping that is not the case. Oh, okay, no, I'm not anywhere close to the hunters, actually. So, well, oh, shut up, you stupid thing. That is really annoying. I cannot believe that. The gun I had was upgraded. And again, he just put this out this morning, so he probably hasn't balanced it quite well enough, developer, but that happens. problem now is trying to get back to where I recognize where we were before I forget. Always want to bandage yourself too. There's like no spawns, no nothing. Good thing it doesn't take much to make the weapons, but it just gets really frustrating. It does take a lot to make the stupid armor, though. And it sure, I mean, yeah, I took a lot of rounds, but I lit that dude up almost the same, if not more, and he lit me, and he was just fine. And I don't know about that. Okay, so we are going to run out of time soon. So, where is the beacon? There's home. Oh, geez. We got quite the run to get back to where we were. That sucks. Which means our stuff will probably be gone. But yeah, you know, and one thing I see consistently is hitbox problems when it comes to any kind of shooter by indie developers. A lot of times, that's usually one of the things that you see is the hitboxes and weapon aiming. Things always, you know, things are usually off just a bit. So they seem to be tightened up, obviously. So, and the other thing that sucks is, you know, it's not just one hunter. It is two. I thought it was, because before I'd only run into one, but now, obviously, they're running multiple hunters at you at one time. So, could just be I hadn't run into that yet. Hello, bear. But man, talk about no spawns. Oh well, can always, as we're running back, keep our eyes open for more camps and hunters, because we may find them again. Oh look, finally something to grab. All right, woohoo! You shouldn't burn your energy quite as fast as I have been, because anything that chases me now is going to be able to run me down. Man, that just... Oh, oh well. So our base is over there to the right. These guys are up here, I think, over here at this tree. Right? We are in this area. Now, one thing that doesn't and it hasn't happened yet, and I'm waiting for, and that is the wolves and the bears to interact with the hunters. Right now, they kind of just pretend they neither one exists. And I would, for one, would like to see that change. Because, you know, I'll make things a little more fair. Or was it over there? Oh, there he is. There's one of the hunters. So, yeah, okay, so we need to go on the other side of that ridge, see if our stuff is gone. Okay, good. Stamina's coming back up. Just got to make sure we go around far enough where they don't see us. Which is always kind of a guessing game with a game like this, because you still, we're not, you know, I'm still not 100% sure of all the areas, how far stuff lets you see. Right, this is where we got smoked. Of course, there's a wolf there. The question is our stuff here? Oh, god damn it. So the other thing I've noticed is that the wolves will camp things. Whoop. Hopefully he doesn't see me. No, I don't see our gear anywhere. God damn it. You're kidding me. I wonder if that means if I... We could always suicide after the guys. Uh-oh. I think he knows I'm here now. Yep. Jeez, how many bullets do you have? I'm gonna wait till he's out of bullets, then I'll go kill him. You out of bullets, mate? Might as well have fun since I lost all my shit. Okay. You can see how fast they're armoring up now, right? And I just turned these on, so these guys have had like maybe 2 days. To armor up. I just start building their stuff. So. We'll just start trekking back, I guess. I think this, yeah, that's the main mountain. So we'd be going up this way, I think. You know, and then there's always the fun question of... how fast they heal, right? Because you never know. They could be 100% healed as soon as you walk away from them. Depends on how the dev set that up. I'm not sure. Yeah, I think I know where I'm going. They should be right over here, around here again. Yep. So, the wolves and the bears, when they eat you and kill you, they automatically rise in level. Oh, shit. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, I found him again. Oh, and I died again. God damn it. Obviously, I haven't played a lot with the hunters and screwed around with them, but... Jeez, actually, we should be right back this way, right? We have that mountain. Oh, wow. Now we're going to wind up having to wait. Oh, shit. Well, we might be able to get more one more run at him. Now I killed one of them off. Maybe I can get the other one. Go. Maybe we'll pick up something we can use. Because I don't want to waste my rifle. I don't want to take my rifle out yet. We can do that on the marrow. But again, a lot of it's balance issues. You know, it's all good. And you do start out with a handgun, by the way. You guys know, so the hunters start out the same stuff that you do. Oh, shut up, bear. Oh, it's going to be jacked, because I didn't look that close, but what I ran up on, if that's another group of hunters. Because that first group, right there, I see him. Whoop. Wrong button. All right. What the hell is that? See what I'm saying with that wolf right through the center of that camp? That's bullshit. So now there's one right there, too. You're kidding me, right? So now this dude's guarded by, that's not fair. That's infuriating. Oh, well, life isn't fair. True, true. Ever so true. Let's see. So the question's going to be, can we kill this dude? Where'd he go? Where'd he go? Oh, crap. Where'd he go? Did he die? Yes. What? Oh, I just got totally screwed on that. Look at this. So I kill the hunters, and this is what I get. And I get a wolf trying to kill me. So we'll just run back to base. And this is the real dangerous part. That's okay, I should be able to make another gun pretty easily. The reason this is so dangerous... Yeah, see, now I've got... Oh, that's okay. But the reason it gets so dangerous is I can't tell if I'm going to run off any hills or not. Still after me, bad puppy? I'd like this med pack. Or ammo pack. Oh, well. Ooh, and now we're getting code. It's okay, we'll be home relatively quickly, I think. Yeah, we're good. Alright. So you guys can see, Yes, you can take them out with an axe, but they don't have really any good goodies until they get their own bases built. So now that we killed those two guys out, they're going to come back stronger. Okay, we're home. And what is this doing? Now, matches. I figured out what was going on with the matches. So the matches now, you have to get matches from hunters, but you can make your own. Whoop. Get in there. Thank you. You can make your own. There we go. Matches right here. It's a fire starting kit, so it's two sticks, which you make with a couple of pieces of wood. A couple of fibers and biofuel. So, well, at least I still got my one gun here. I got 11 rounds of that. I just don't like using it because it's good for sniping, but it's not strong enough to kill them in one shot. You know what I'm saying? So, but let's see. What does it take for us to make a new gun? It don't take squat dilly. Do do do. I should have some of that over here. Yep. Boom. And another shotgun. That I might have to work on because I don't have the requested cloth yet. And then, let's see, padded cloth. Make another one of those. Start working on trying to make us some clothes here. And unfortunately, again, the only way you can make cloth is with cotton. I'd really like to see him put that resource into the world. Personally. Alright, so let's put all my materials away. Remember, if you guys saw my last stream, you would have saw that. Holy crap, look at the amount of nails that he has. Oh yeah. But something you can do is then go build multiple little bases, because you can build another one of those. You can build a whole nother powered base, so you can put multiple bases around it and out if you want. Let's see. And since we're about out of our health kits, let me make up. Oh, did I use it? I used it all. Damn it. Oh well. Our gun's made. Another really important thing we're going to need, of course, is going to be our pickaxe. So we can continue to make this stuff. Because, if I remember correctly, it didn't take a whole lot to upgrade this thing the first time around. We have to bump some juice, but I've got the weapons parts. So the question would be, do we do this or do we wait for the shotgun? Because shooting in the core didn't do a whole lot, because that's what I was trying to do. You know, like most, I think, individuals would. It's okay. We'll just take and carry a crap ton of ammo. Because I can make a few of these at least. Wham, wham. There we go. Oh, also, give me a chance now to show you how to do the armor. So, various pieces take various amounts, but you have to build yourself a hammer. You can make a hammer. Yeah. At the very bottom here. Hammer. Lockpick. Because, oh, I wish I remember where that little, that special weapons crate was. Actually, what does it take to make a I need to make another one anyways. I just used one. Really, that's all I need is 18 of those? Do I have that much? That's a good question. Yes, I do. Cool. Oh. And we don't got enough juice. Really? Son of a biscuit. So we'll turn that off. So one thing you will notice, as you get more and more things, you will be kept busier and busier. I see our sun's up again, so we're going to want to get our butts back out there. Whoop, wrong button. But the reason I run two generators is I can then put 3%, three pop in, at once here. See how this thing's rocking on up now? We're waiting for our ammo. So we just got to wait for that, for it to hit 500. Shouldn't be too difficult. So we've got health kits, splint in case you, if you jump too far, you will break your leg. Of course, bandages and cloth, and not enough cloth for that to really work very well, though I still got my extra backup here. We're not doing too much. Let's go put some of this ammo away. Put that stuff back. I don't know if I should take my rifle. I might take the rifle with us. See if we run across somebody from a distance, I'll snipe them. See how well it works. Food-wise, everything's pretty much okay. Should probably... Oh, yeah, water. Totally forgot about water and my animals. All right, so how much... Hurry up, get back in there. Come on. Yeah. Okay, so, making armor is up to you how and where you want to put it, but let me think. I'm thinking probably we're going to want to go right here. So all you have to do is get close and hit the use key, which is F. And it's now 1500 to make those. Takes two pieces of scrap, four iron fragments, two pieces of zinc, but it takes anywhere from 3 to 4 to armor up one area. So you want to keep that in mind. Let's see. Those supplies. Woo! What about time to make another fuel brick? Reminds me. Turn that off. Put the ashes over here. Because I know you can't. I don't remember. Let me see. Is it gunpowder? Yeah, that's the potassium and ash. And then ammo casings. See, these are the easy. Those are. Wow, look. That's it. Really? Oh, wow. I didn't know it took that much to ash. Okay. Ooh, well, we'll move those over. pull the copper out. I have a crap load of potassium. So much potassium. I'm gonna split for one round and let that run. Because I was gonna say we can make like what? One. That's funny. At least it doesn't cost anything versus this, the ammo casings, which are, this is the, that's the expensive one because it takes six for one round and four for the rifles. So very, very spendy. Take some stuff here to our chickens. Because basically you want to get your coop first because you need the fertilizer to be able to fertilize your plants. So you build your plant second, fertilizer first. After you catch... Oh no, they all died. Well, we'll butcher a couple of them. That's fine, I don't care. They're not that hard to catch. I mean, basically, you just run behind them, right, until they give up. Or you can shoot them. That's another thing that you can do. But that food will go bad on us. And brick here fuel, that'll fill this whole fuel thing up, so you want to make sure you do not use that. Let's see. Put those away. Oh. And I don't have any more matches, do I? Ah, biofuel and sticks. There we go. I'm going to have to get me some more wood and not actually make it as I'm running around for once. We'll cook us some chicken, then we will go hunt. Unfortunately, I don't have any fat to render. You can get fat off of wolves and bears. Oh my. Oh, you get 10 for one of those, huh? Oh, okay. It's not too bad. Food sizzling away. Need iron more than anything else, I think. Let's see. Put those back. See, and unfortunately, even the medium, I mean, you look here. You gotta grow a crap load of cloth. That's ridiculous. I mean, it just makes it out of reach. At least for me. I mean, I don't know. But the cool part is, you know, if you get overwhelmed by the hunters and giving you a hard time, you can just turn them off. So, and then turn them back on and they'll start all over. So it does make things easier on you. We do not want to take that with us. We will take the rifle, though. Whoop! Alright. Boom. And let's see. So the upgrades I've done so far with the rifle, so far, when you add rounds, you get one round per upgrade, and that's not cool. And then there's another, same for the shotgun. It's like you get one round more. I just don't care for that, personally. I think you should get more on that, but let's see. Time to go. Whoops. Oh. No, that's where those go. Okay. Just ticking my rounds with me. Ooh, almost forgot about my chicken. I don't know how many times I've done that. Look how fast that went. Really? Damn, son. There we go. Got plenty of that. And water-wise. See, it's not quite done yet, so let's just... we'll take our run, see what we can find. So we have guys over here on our right side of our map. That makes me think that we're gonna have hunters over here to the up here. Oh, something else I learned: don't push your luck trying to pick up things. If there is a wolf or a bear close to it, move on. I don't know how many times I've gotten killed because I'm trying to, you know. Oh, hey. Oh, wow, that guy's pretty far. Let's go see if we can get in this position and snipe him. Stop moving. See, now we should be able to get all of his gear. Let me get closer. You know what I'm saying? We should be able to get everything off of him, not just a few things. Uh-oh, might have saw me. Really? So that was right at his head. There'll be another one around here. Ooh, good. We got some parts this time. Should be another one. See, now what sucks is you can't get anything here until got anything here? Yeah, we'll take, you know what? We're gonna turn your fire off and we're gonna take the ash. But they're supposed to have crates of stuff that you can get. And so far, no luck. Nope, damn it, I forgot to grab the lockpick. Oh well. That's cool. But yeah, so as you guys can see, the fire's a real big giveaway. Real big. So there's some water. Again, unless you're desperate for food, try to avoid all of the angry wildlife. Although I do hope he adds more wildlife. It would be nice. And again, having the animals actually react. So I got full juice. Alright, let's see if we can run this chicken down. The thing with chickens is that they were only run so far, and then they pause, or if they run into something, you can catch them. So you see we're getting closer and closer here. Just got to make sure you've got enough running capability to get him, and then when you get right close to him, we will catch him. There we go. All right. There we go. So we got a new chicken. So we'll go put our chicken back. Because I don't want the chicken to get choked in the bag, you know. Oh, God, that joke hurt. Oh, that was horrible. This is where I had my old base in one of my other build. And I was like, screw it. Just easier to start over. What I should have done is just deconstructed that base and gone from there, because, well, look who we just found. I'm not going to kill this one. We're going to let him live. Because I want that base to get built. But see, that last guy we shot in the face, we didn't get up. Oh, shit. So that would be two hunters. You know, if you guys are going to be that way, which asshole shot at me? Who did I miss? I sure the hell didn't see. Ah, damn it. Where the other guy was shooting me from. So, okay, if they want to come over here, man, there's all kinds of stuff. The reason I like where I put this base is the hunters tend to hug walls, and so I've got this whole giant U-turn here to shoot them. Unless I'm in my base, and then I've got the high ground, and I can kill them yet again very easily, so. Now, something to keep in mind is food does go bad on you. So eventually you can make a refrigerator if you've got sorry, I hope you didn't see that. Here, have some water. This should be done. I'm just going to let that run for a while. Ooh, did I not grab any fertilizer out here, or I'm already out of fertilizer? I have one. Kind of a bummer. And these guys, I don't think die, it'll just slow them down. So now we've got plenty to do with upgrade, but we should probably cook this food before we lose it. Didn't get any matches off those guys either. Stickaroos. Oh, there we go. Helps when I hit the right key. I'm gonna have to go get some wood. Yep, that's what it looks like. You get healed up too. Yeah, you see the guys I already killed now, I don't have any. Stuff to really protect me now. And that was fast. I mean, I prepped all weekend to go after these guys. You guys saw how. Again, it could be game bug, you know, it could be a lot of things. It could be that the upgrades aren't actually registering correctly. Could be that. Could be a lot of things. Hey, puppy. You guys wouldn't stand over crates so much. So the next question would be, how fast do these guys respawn? That I do not know. So far, when I've killed off hunters, it's been a while since I've seen him again. So wasn't there... Let's see. Right, it was over here somewhere. Oh well. It's all good. So there you guys go. I think we're doing, give you guys a pretty decent idea today what it's like screwing with these hunters. Definitely makes things a lot harder and a lot more fun, that's for sure. Just takes way too much time to get to the point where you can do combat with them. And if anything I would say to the developer is you need to shorten up what it takes to get a character geared up. Way too much time. So that would be the only thing I would say about this one currently, is that it just needs to balance, you know, rebalance. Still a lot of fun though. This is one of the ones I've got put aside that I keep playing because I really enjoy playing it. Very relaxing. Definitely a cool game. So please, folks, as with the current debacle these days with YouTube and AdSense, if you guys could donate to my channel, I'd greatly appreciate it. I do spend a lot of time going over all of this and doing my best to give you guys the best show that I can here for Indie Contact. So please like, favorite, and subscribe, and share so that we can get the devs as much exposure as possible, and give me as much exposure as possible so that I can continue to help them. The bigger my channel gets, the more I'm given press copy. Like right now, I probably got 100 requests out, and we'll see if I get anything. Always up, down, left, right, so. But that's okay. I've got a lot of games that you guys probably have never seen or heard of, and probably quite a few that you have that are indie that we can always revisit, check out. I'm gonna have to watch every time I come running over here. Really? What do you think you're doing, dog? I'm just gonna run right by you. Ooh! It's like an angry wife talking to you. Ooh! Watch out. Aha! Now, something you want to keep in mind, and I do this a lot, is I bring animals over here when I've got a lot of ammo or something. Really? You're going to stop? You think that's a good idea, huh? All right, something to keep in mind. If you know where Hunter are, don't put your back to him when you do what I'm about to do, which is... Butcher. This is how you... And you can do this with bears, too. Well, at least we got some... leather now. It's all good. What's up, chicken? There we go. Doo-doo. I know, I start to do a close the stream and I get sidetracked because there's so much to do. That tends to happen a lot. Oh, it's a whisker fart of goodness. Alright. Alrighty, folks, so please like, favorite, and subscribe. If there's a game that you know of that you'd like to see on the show, let me know, and we will see about making that happen. If it has at least an hour's worth of content and is stable enough that it won't crash. And you never know with that. So please, like, favorite, and subscribe. Keep your heads down. Yo, guns up, and I'll see you again tomorrow, 1 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. I'll see you then.